In this video, we will see how to solve the problem of Windows update getting stuck on checking for updates step. We will see four methods to resolve it. Hi friends, welcome to our YouTube channel howisolve.com. This is Neil, your expert troubleshooter. This problem of Windows update getting stuck on checking for update step can happen due to many reasons. So we have come up with the best four methods to solve it. You can see those methods on the left side of your screen, and you can skip to the method you want to choose by clicking on them. Before we start this tutorial, I would like to state a couple of assumptions we are undertaking. Firstly, you have got a genuine activated copy of Windows. Second, you are using Windows 7 SP1 or Windows 8.1 or Windows 10. For other OSs, this tutorial might work, but we cannot guarantee that. Thirdly, your internet connection is working properly. And fourth, you have got admin rights to the system which you want to troubleshoot. With that, let's now dive into method 1, running Windows update for an hour. With the growing volume of Windows update packages, the process of selecting the suitable package for your system can be very time consuming for the Windows update agent. Several people have reported that the checking for update step took them approximately an hour, after which the Windows update started working properly. So if you have not left your computer on checking for update stage for an hour, I would suggest you to try it out. But before we do that, we'll make some changes in your system so that the system doesn't go to sleep and there is no problem with your internet connection. By changing your power option settings on Windows 7, click on Start and type Power Option. Click on Power Options. In Windows 8.1, to open Power Options, from the Start screen, type Power in the search panel and then select Power Options. In Windows 10, to open Power Options, right click on the Start button and select Power Option. Depending upon the plan you have chosen, either Balance would be checked or High Performance or Power Saver. Whichever plan yours is showing as selected, click on the Change Plan setting for the same. In my options, I have chosen High Performance, so I'll go and click Change Plan Settings for that particular plan. In that, you will be shown a screen like this. Depending on your device, either only one set of column would be available or both on battery and plugged in columns would be available. What we have to ensure is the put the computer to sleep option is set on never. And also, if you are on using a laptop or any battery powered device, make sure when you are putting your computer on update, it's connected to the power supply. Click on Save Changes. Now, to ensure that your internet is running properly during Windows update, we will flush the DNS settings. For that, in Windows 7, click on Start, type CMD, right click, select Run as Administrator. Click on Yes if a UAC pops up. In Windows 8, to open Command Prompt in admin mode, from the Start screen, type CMD, right click and select Run as Administrator. If a UAC pops up, click on Yes. In Windows 10, to open Command Prompt in admin mode, right click the Start button and select Command Prompt Admin. In the Command Prompt, type ipconfig space slash flush flushdns. Hit Enter. It will show that it has successfully flushed the DNS. This will ensure if there was some problem in your DNS resolution during update, that won't occur again. Keep this admin command prompt open. We'll use it for later purpose. After doing that, again check your Windows update and see whether the problem has resolved or not. Ensure that you keep the Windows update on for at least an hour. If this method didn't work, let's go to method 2. Update the Windows agent. This method applies to Windows 7 SP1 and Windows 8.1. Recently, Windows has released an update for its Windows update agent, which has couple of bug fixes. I have added the download link for the update in the video description. But before we head to them, you should be knowing what if you are using a 32-bit version or a 64-bit version of the OS. If you do not know, type this command in the command prompt: WMIC space OS space get get space os architecture architecture. Hit enter. The output would be OS architecture and your If you have got a 32-bit operating system, it would say OS architecture 32-bit. If you have got a 64-bit, then it would say 64-bit. So after knowing that, let's head on to the download page, the link of which are in the video description. This is the download page of Windows 7 update. If Windows 8 would also be having a similar kind of page. Scroll down and head to method to Microsoft Download Center. So if you have a 32-bit system, you have to download the first link, that is all supported x86 based versions of Windows 7. Click on this download package. Now, if you have got a 64-bit system, then click the second link below. So we'll click on the 64-bit since I have got a 64-bit system. And we'll scroll down and then we'll click download. After that, your download should begin. When it's completed, you would see a MSU file in your downloads folder. Before you run this MSU, you must ensure that the Windows Update agent is not running. Otherwise, it would not allow you to install this update. For that, again, head on to the admin CMD. And type netstop WUAUSERV and hit enter. After that, your update client would stop running, and that would ensure that this setup goes on smoothly. So now we can start the installation. It will ask you whether you want to install this update. Click yes, and then this update installation would start. After this setup has finished, you make sure you restart the system and then check whether your Windows update is working properly or not. Again, ensure that you give sufficient amount of time for the checking for update stage to finish. Click on restart now. If still Windows update keeps showing the checking for updates message, then let's head to method 3. Automated diagnostic tool. Windows has provided a automated diagnostics tool for Windows 7, Windows 8 and Windows 10. The link for the same can be found down in the video description. On opening that link, you would see this page. If you have got Windows 10, then click this link. If you are running Windows 8, 7 or 8.1, click on run now. When the download is completed, you will see a diagnostic cap file in your downloads folder. Click on that application and then click next. It will try to detect any problem and try to solve it. It might take around 15 minutes to complete. After this finishes, try again updating Windows. Again, make sure that you leave it for at least an hour. If none of the above methods worked, method 4 will definitely work. This method applies to Windows 7, 8 and 10 offline Windows update tool. Using this tool, we can create a repository of Windows update files, which then we can transfer to any storage medium like pen drive, external hard disk, etc. Use it for updating Windows machine that has no internet connection. But the main reason why we would be using this is that this tool doesn't rely on the Microsoft's Windows Update client for downloading and installing Windows updates. So even if your update client is not working properly and is broken, this tool can update your Windows system and also repair it. The link for this tool is down in the video description. On clicking on that link, you'll come to this page. Click here where the latest version is available. At this point of time, it is 10.6.2. On clicking that link, you'll find a zip file in your downloads folder. Right click that and extract it. Since I've got WinRAR in my system, so I'll get this extraction option while right clicking itself. But in Windows, without any software also, you can easily extract a zip file. Anyway, so we'll extract it and then open this folder. In this, you'll find an exe file in the WSUS offline folder called updategenerator.exe. Click on that, click run, and then this will download all the updates required for the particular operating system. Depending on your Windows version and architecture, tick the appropriate architecture. Since mine is a Windows 7 system with 64-bit architecture, I'll check this box. And then you can check this include Windows Defender definitions. And rest, you can keep it at default settings. And after that, click start. This will start the downloading process of all the updates required for your particular system. Once this process has finished, you can then go to the clients folder in the same folder where this exe is. Open the clients folder and then open this exe, update installer.exe. Click yes. And then in the controls, you can check on automatic reboot and recall. this, click yes and then click on start. This will automatically install all your downloaded update in your system. And that's it guys. After this, you should have a properly updated Windows machine, and also your Windows update client should work properly. I hope this video helped you, and if so, please hit the subscribe button. You can also share this video by hitting the share button. This would help others who are having a similar problem find this video easily. Please leave your feedback and your valuable comments down in the comment section. I cannot reply to everyone, but I surely read each and every comment. Again, thanks for watching guys. See you later. Bye.